Hi there, welcome back to video number two. Thanks for joining us. In this particular video, we're going to continue with the process of how you can record using Screencastify. In the first video, we talked about how to install the app. Now we're going to utilize that app and actually go through the recording. So within our Chrome browser here, I'm going to activate the Chrome extension here, and I'm going to go ahead and select that, and it's going to open up a new window here, prompting me to record. In this case, it's going to record the desktop, but I could choose to record just a tab, or I could record from the camera. We're going to use the desktop application because that gives you the most flexibility, not only recording the tab, but it allows you to jump from other tabs and record using other applications such as Smart Notebook or maybe some other Microsoft applications if you had those you wanted to use. Under desktop, there's some settings you want to step through. First of all, you want to make sure the microphone is active in recording and picking up your voice. If it's not, you can select the down arrow here and choose the built-in microphone option. Next to video, there's an option here. When you click the three little dots, you can choose to turn on a 3-second countdown timer. The other option is to embed a webcam, so you can show your face while you're talking. That little webcam picture of you will be in the bottom right-hand corner or in the top right. There are some different options of where you can put that little webcam. So I'm just going to leave mine in the bottom right-hand corner. We are not going to use a preview window in this case, and I'm going to go ahead and click Record Desktop. When I click that option, it's giving me a little confirmation here that it's going to record my entire screen. And when I click share, it's going to give me a 3-second countdown timer and I'll be ready to go. So here we go.
3, 2, 1.
And now I'm live. So what it's doing is it's picking up my voice, obviously, as well as any mouse clicks or any navigation that I perform with my cursor here. That's all being recorded through the Screencastify application. In this case, I'm in my Google Slideshow, but I could go to a website as well. That recording is still continuing, even though I'm in a separate tab here. So now I can voice over my presentation here on this website, which is just about the rainforest. I can talk about whatever information is being displayed here. And when I'm ready to end my presentation or my Screencastify app, I can go ahead and click Stop Sharing. And it's going to open up a new window. And it's going to give me options for where I can save this video. In the next video segment, we're going to talk about your options for saving and how to navigate the Google Drive where all this information is saved. Thank you and stay tuned.